You know, this has been a bad year for cruise ships. Between headlines of passengers getting stuck on board for weeks at end to the pandemic putting vacations on hold, how could things possibly get any worse? Well, Dread Nautical has the answer to that question, and it's zombies. In this new game from Zen Studios, we go through every harrowing deck of a cruise liner, fighting the undead and locating survivors. Too bad the real villain of this game isn't some evil mastermind or a bunch of brain-eating zombies, but rather the clunky gameplay and randomly constructed levels. This is the intriguing story of what happens when a luxury liner named Hope gets sucked into an alternate dimension filled with zombies and mutants. But it's actually a lot more interesting than that, because the few survivors appear to be stuck in a time loop where they repeat the day every time they blow the horn. And is it possible that our four heroes have been guided to the cruise ship by an outside force? What's going on? That's something you're gonna need to piece together as you guide four colorful characters through 20 decks of vacation hell. Guide is probably the right word to put it, because Dread Nautical is a turn-based strategy game. We point and click our way around the randomly constructed decks until we locate the bad guys, where we're forced to think tactically. The idea is to use all your points attacking the enemy and moving out of the way, at which point the zombies take their turn and all you can do is hope for the best. It's a back and forth struggle until somebody wins, at which point you go back to exploring the decks for more powerful weapons and health items. Unless you're the one that died, of course. If you end up getting eaten along the way, then you're gonna have to start the day all over again and hope for better luck. So at first, the adventure revolves around the four hero characters, which each have their own unique personalities and abilities. But as you clear the decks and make the cruise ship safer, you'll end up running into a number of eccentric survivors that all need your help. The trick is to run errands for them and say the right thing in order for you to win their trust. Ideally, they'll team up with you in order to fight off the evil monsters populating the decks. However, this comes with a cost. Housing a bunch of survivors comes with responsibilities such as feeding them and making sure that they're in tip-top condition. This means that you'll need to be even more thorough when it comes to exploring every level and need to make tough decisions when it comes to who eats and who doesn't. Now, befriending the survivors is crucial because you'll be able to construct teams with them of up to three fighters. Taking on the zombies is challenging on your own because you initially don't have enough action points to escape, so having backup is a must if you intend to reach the higher decks and uncover the secrets of this mystery. The good news is that you can upgrade every character and repair the weapons you collect, allowing you to go into each deck prepared. In fact, the main hub has a lot of useful upgrade stations to put your hard-earned points into, so you may want to go back and replay some of the earlier levels to grind for experience. Now, this is the type of game that grew on me over time. Look, I'm gonna be honest, I kinda hated the early stages of Dread Nautical, especially when I was on my own trying to kill the ghouls infesting the cruise ship. I never had enough action points to both attack and also get out of the way from harm. Thankfully, things improved considerably as I upgraded my hero and recruited more help, but the turn-based gameplay never fully clicked with me. It's incredibly simplistic when compared to other strategy games, and I ultimately felt that the gameplay was too limited for what they were trying to accomplish. I had an especially hard time moving my characters around using the PlayStation 4 controller. I don't know, perhaps this works better with a mouse and keyboard, but the analog sticks weren't precise enough to do what I needed them to do, and that led to an endless amount of frustration. I also don't like how all the decks are randomly constructed. Don't get me wrong, I normally don't have anything against procedurally created stages, but too many of the decks look and play out the exact same way. You'll see the same rooms filled with the same enemies that drop the same items. And let me tell you, it got old after a while. I feel like the randomness of the levels detracts from the inherent fun of being on a cruise ship. I mean, it's not hard to imagine these cool and elaborate decks that feel wholly unique and special. But all that goes out the window when you enter the same kitchen or bathroom for the 10th time in a row. All this is a shame because the gameplay and repetitive level designs nearly ruin a really cool setup. Even though I'm a little tired of zombies at this point, the overall story is genuinely interesting, and I was curious to see what it was leading to. I also loved the over-the-top survivors, especially the four hero characters. I knew I was gonna love this cast the moment I saw them, which is one of the reasons why I was so disappointed by the execution. Killing zombies on a cruise ship should be a lot more fun than this. Just when you think things can't possibly get any worse for the cruise ship industry, here comes Dreadnautical. This is a strategy survival game with a colorful cast of characters and 20 stages to fight through. Although the setup is fun and there's a lot to upgrade, this new release from Zen Studios is occasionally hard to control and far too repetitive. It squanders a cool premise with levels that are hard to tell apart and a campaign that takes too long to get going. I like the humor and the atmosphere, but Dreadnautical ultimately left me stranded at sea. Hey, thanks for watching our review. If you like what you saw here, then you should know that we post new reviews and features, well, throughout the week. Now here's the question I have for you. What is your favorite horror game setting? Are you a fan of spooky mansions, or schools, or cruise ships, or something else? Let me see your thoughts in the comments below. Also, while editing this video, I noticed that it's more monsters than zombies. I mean, zombies are definitely in the mix, but there are a bunch of different types of monsters, so hopefully you won't leave a comment complaining that it's not just a zombie game. In other news, we'll be back tomorrow with an epic, and I mean epic, TurboGrafx-16 countdown. Oh man, this thing is gonna blow you away. If that sounds good to you, then I strongly recommend you click that subscribe button and support what we're doing here. Until then.